Lake Druzhno, several kilometers from the Vistula Bay. We are sailing in a small boat, the only way to sail in the more and more shallow water. The lake becomes increasingly silted up and grown over. This process in nature is slow. Once people get involved, they build dams and soon the lake's bottom changes into cultivable fields. The Zouave region is an example of the above described actions. The Mennonites in Zouave, legacy of work. Vistula Zouave, the region of 1700 square kilometers in the delta of the Vistula originating in the bifurcation of the Vistula and the Nogat in Biała Góra. The Vistula Delta was formed in the long-lasting process of drifting the river deposits. It is a wet plain whose depressions constitute almost 30% of its area. Enormous efforts and special skills were needed to bring this land into cultivation. It took many generations to build the drainage systems, the swamps were dried and new regions prepared. The Zouave landscape, with its configuration and flora, is thus the heritage of work carried out for many hundred years. Archaeologists have not found any traces of prehistoric settlements. Only some fishermen, including seal and amber fishers, came to the hills protecting themselves against water. The development of Zouave was initiated in the 12th century when natural processes of delta formation were replaced by some organized, planned actions. The map, which reconstructs Zouave in the 13th century, depicts the first villages, Gdańsk and Elbląg. It also shows Malbork, the capital of a powerful country created by the Order of Our Lady, transferred from Venice in 1309. The splendor of the Malbork Castle indicates that the country had the most efficient administration and economy. The big castle storerooms were being filled with goods thanks to, among other things, the development and cultivation of Zouave. First, the fields were protected against river floods. The dams were built by the settlers brought there from Western Europe by the Teutonic Knights, and the Zouave rivers started to be controlled. The Gothic churches, several dozen of which were preserved, prove that the first stage of the development of Zouave was successful. By the end of the 14th century, about 80 villages were built in Zouave. The symbols of Zouave in the next centuries are the granaries. especially those in Gdańsk and Elbląg, which after the 13-year war became Poland's main ports. Thanks to them, Baltic trade became possible. The profitable export of crops gave rise to the most wonderful development of these towns, and indirectly helped in the next stage of bringing Żuławy into cultivation. More settlers followed into Żuławy, mainly radical Protestants, the Mennonites, called after their leader Menno Simons. Severe persecutions made them search for the country in which their strict rules would be accepted, such as no external interference, no christening, living in closed communities. The settlers came mainly from the Netherlands. In Poland, they were allowed to live according to their rules, and therefore, one of them wrote, "Happy New Holland lies at the Vistula mouth." The Mennonites settled in the deserted villages of Żuławy and started to drain new areas. Some new villages were built in the northern and eastern part of the delta, the part which had been earlier filled with water. Maps from the 17th and 18th centuries show polders, drained and cultivated areas fully covered with dams and canals. Olenzy, Dutchmen, as they were called, did know how to build drainage systems. What kinds of trees to grow to support them, and how to build houses on terps, the piled hills protecting against periodic floods. The windmills became characteristic of the Żuławy landscape. There were hundreds of them, varying in construction, water pumping systems and grinding techniques. They are depicted on tiles called delves, which decorated the then houses. The houses of Olenzy were similar to those built near the North Sea. This slide shows a typical one-mansion house. Its form underwent some changes, but it was always a complex situated under one roof. Let us see the house more closely. The house with a relatively narrow top is continuous with the byre and the barn and constitutes a long building. The area is fully used and common walls save heat. The village and field arrangement in Żuławy varied. Here are some examples. The road-like layout. The houses are situated along the road. The oval system. The road forms an oval with a square in the middle. And the water road-like layout. The river or canal instead of the road. Despite many changes, these old arrangement systems can still be seen in many villages. The Zhuave villages were small, as the farms covered even over 100 hectares. Their wealth is best demonstrated by the famous arcade houses. Their sizes can be compared to manors rather than to country houses. And the interior, sculptured furniture, decorated stoves, artistic doors, high-quality fabrics, china, silverware, all this proves that the owners were rich. The arcade houses varied in form. However, the arcade, supported by several pillars, was characteristic of all of them. The walls were mostly built of wooden frames filled with masonry. The houses were surrounded by orchards, gardens, farm buildings, sometimes ponds. As you can see, this was the center of an effective and well-organized farm. In 1772, Poland was partitioned and Zhuave became part of Prussia. A map from that period shows that Zhuave were already developed and brought into cultivation. And a wave of new settlers intensified the local economy. The economy of Zhuave was mainly based on crop and sugar beet growing and stork breeding, and thus the processing industry was developed. This is a water mill and a sugar factory in Nowy Dwór, the capital of Zhuave. The factories obviously used the water network. The crops were directly transported from farms in flat-bottomed punts. Numerous sugar and groat factories, breweries, dairies and oil mills were built. However, the most famous product of Zhuave was its Maschandel vodka. The vodka was produced at a distillery owned by the successive generations of the Stobbe family. Gustav Nord, a famous Gdańsk actor, played in the Stobbe Maschandel advertisements. Obviously, agriculture remained most relevant in Zhuave. However, the living conditions of the main farmers, the Mennonites, radically changed. In the militarized countries such as Prussia, their distinct rules of life, especially those concerning a refusal to serve in the army, were not tolerated. And so, some Mennonites left for Russia and settled near the Black Sea. Others assimilated with the German community. This process can be seen in the increasingly uniform buildings found in Zouave. Red bricks became the most prevailing elements, similarly to other parts of Prussia. However, the buildings were still decorated with wood carving, so characteristic of wooden Dutch Hollander structures. In 1888, a severe flood proved that Zouave, although developed and cultivated, was not yet under full control. And so, further efforts were made to regulate rivers, to build dams and new bridges. Among other things, the Nogat was finally closed by a new floodgate in Biała Góra. The Vistula was protected with high dams. Inland navigation conditions were markedly improved and the risk of flooding was decreased. It seemed that the Zouave region was protected against the forces of nature. However, it appeared that the disaster was to be brought about by a conscious act of man. World War II severely affected Zouave in the winter of 1945 when the Red Army offensive engaged Prussia. The retreating German soldiers blew up dams in 16 different places and Zouave were flooded. 1,600 farms were under water. After the war, Zouave were again within Polish borders. One more effort was made to bring the region into cultivation. However, this was not easy as the whole population was displaced to Germany and the cultural continuity of Zouave was disrupted. The newcomers and emigrants from the east settled in the deserted areas. Many of them did not manage in such difficult conditions and left the devastated farms. Nevertheless, step by step, Zouave was recovering. A pump station was built and water was again under control. Yet the undergoing changes were strange to this land. The collectivization of agriculture required a wider range of field integration. A new building development was no longer a continuation of traditional forms and layouts. Fortunately, these changes did not affect the preserved enclaves of natural environment. These enclaves were changed into wildlife and landscape sanctuaries. The most valuable ecosystems are those of the Elbląg Bay and Lake Drużno sanctuaries. Over 200 species of birds were observed there, which constitutes half of all bird species found in Poland. If you look at the Zouave landscape from its water routes, which are so attractive for tourists, you can see that its traditional character is still preserved in many places. The boundaries of fields and farms are still marked by the lines of trees, embankments and drainage ditches. And this must not be changed. Further existence of the Zouave entirely depends on the continuation of work carried out by our predecessors. Above all, the water system must be maintained, although it should be modernized. Moreover, many old technical devices may still be used. On the other hand, the buildings and equipment which no longer serve their function should be preserved as monuments, since they are so important elements of the Zhuave landscape and culture. And the same concerns the people who created all this. Zhuave is the heritage of their work, carried out for 700 years. And their tombstones are just a tiny part of what these old landholders left for future generations.